お呼びしましょう。大きな拍手でお迎えください。まずはプロデューサーのチャールズ・ローブンさん。デボラ・スナイダーさん。ザック・スナイダー監督。クラーク・ケントを演じましたヘンリー・カビルさん。
スーパーマンという大役を演じるまでには様々なご苦労があったと思いますが、演じる前と演じた後とで何かこう環境的に変わったことがあったら教えてください。
Well, there's been a change in private life and professional life, quite a dramatic change. There's when you do a movie like Superman, or when you play Superman, you do a movie like Man of Steel, then the professional life seems to ramp up a bit. People get very excited about the idea of working with you, and so it's been a wonderful change in that instead of me trying to find scripts and any script that comes along which I get the job offer for, I'll take because I would need to keep working. Instead, it's more of more scripts coming my way and I get the opportunity to tell the stories that I would like to tell. And in private life, well, you know, walking down the street's a little bit more difficult now and Starbucks isn't quite so familiar a haunt as it used to be. But it's, you know, everything changes in time and it's about finding the positives in change.
今回コスチュームも、イメージが一新されていて、赤いパンツを履いていないというのが個人的にはとても印象的だったんですが。
So you wanted to see him with his pants on, is what you're saying. I've gone on long rants about the sort of origins of the underwear on the outside of the pants and how it relates to, you know, Victorian era strong men, and how in the Victorian era, of course, you know, no skin, they couldn't show any skin, so a strong man would put tight flesh-colored tights on and then put the underwear over the tights to simulate a nude figure. And over time, this circus thought it'd be cute to put different colored tights on underneath. And then when the Superman costume was being developed in its infancy, of course, a strong man from the circus was inspirational. And so we were left now, 100 years later, more, 150 years later, with these underwear outside the pants of the character. So we felt like maybe it was time we could move on from our Victorian roots to a more maybe modern version of the suit. Sorry about the technical.
フリージャーナリストの渡辺直美です。よろしくお願いします。ヘンリーさんにご質問させていただきたいんですけども、もしスーパーマンのように空を飛べたら日本のどこに行きたいですか？
I wish I knew more about Japan so I could actually sort of make a very informed decision and give you a good answer on that. But surely, if I could fly like Superman, I could go everywhere in Japan, could I not? If I had to choose one place, I would probably say Kyoto, because I've heard so much about it. I'd love to visit it. And if not Kyoto, then maybe the summit of Mount Fuji.
例えば、なんかいろいろ変わったりとかしないですか？まあ、もしよかったら。
ああ、こんな人がいいな。ああ、常識ある人がいいですね。常識ある人と、お箸ちゃんと持てる人。
箸
意外と持てない人多いじゃないですか。綾部さんがそうなんですけど、本当に汚くて持ち方が。で、くちゃくちゃ食べるんですよね。で、くちゃくちゃ食べてるから、出てくるの食べ物が。ニャンニャンニャンニャンニャンみたいな。それがすごい嫌で、そういう男性は嫌です。それ以外の方だったらもらえるけど、見た目とかは全然タイプないんで、
うん、年齢的には
年齢も全然大丈夫です。めっちゃ幅広いです。
ちなみにどのぐらい上から下まで？
下はまあ18歳から上80まで大丈夫です。
80ですか？
はい、もう元気であれば、うん